accept the Lord Jesus, my brother?
Four blackout connecting the south side.
I hope those were fireworks.
Darkness is always right around the corner.
What's happening, YouTube? This is going to be my Shy Episode 5 trailer review and breakdown. And if you're new to this channel, the way we do this is we go through the trailer and we slow it down and go clip by clip because they try to sneak some stuff in there that might can give us some clues to what's going on in the next episode. Episode 4 was pretty good. I'm anxious to see how they're going to bring back some of the people that we didn't get to see in that episode. So please subscribe to this channel. Be sure to join me live when I go on with Larry, 9 p.m. Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And be on the lookout for the Baby L videos. Let's watch the trailer one more time. Then we'll slow it down and break it down frame by frame.
That girl's still missing.
I'm not worried. You'll find her.
Very first frame, ladies and gentlemen. We seen this one coming. We saw Ronnie at the end of episode 4 go back to Papa's daddy's church. But now, ladies and gentlemen, we've got questions about Papa's daddy being a pastor by accepting bribe money from Lena Waithe as she's trying to run for office. Needless to say, that doesn't hinder Ronnie's quest to do better, Ronnie's goal to do better. And right here, he's just getting baptized. And if you can recall, this was in the trailer from the summertime, so we knew this was gonna happen. Then we see there's having some kind of bad storm on the south side. All the lights are going out. We see Kevin and his militant sister. I'm so happy that they're doing together. But ladies and gentlemen, there will be a conflict with these two. The streets is telling me the conflict could be that Jake might try to impose on this young lady because due to his current daddy to be, and this young lady's daddy's got money, they might be hooking up on the campaign. I'm telling y'all, there's gonna be some conflict, but for this particular trailer, they're just walking around, the lights are going out, she's talking about fireworks, whatever may have you. Next clip, we see Duda, and man, he's scheming something, but exactly what is it that he's scheming? It could be the fact that he's upset about that money that went missing. And he's trying to figure out how to handle that. Remember, Trigg stole that money from one of his guys? He might be thinking about them chickens coming home to roost. Then we see Kev and his girl out. And then this old ugly-ass, mud-ass dog scares them as if this is going to be a horror episode. Y'all see that little thing looking like one of them dogs we would see in some of those Espanol movies that they have in the Lowriders? Man, get that dog out of here. Then we go right back to Duda, and he's beating up somebody. And if can you see over his right shoulder, that is Jake standing by the door looking in like, whoa, this dude a killer? And then you see Duda done beat the dude down, threw him to the ground, standing beside Perry's Pizza. And then we see Jake just like, what in the hell is going on? Like, I ain't know this dude was about that life. Very next clip that they scroll by very fast. This looks to be Trigg talking to possibly Jake. Comment below if y'all know who this is because it was very dark. I could barely zoom in to see who it is. But I think it's Jake going to talk to Trigg about what happened with Duda, Duda's explosion. And I think we're going to start seeing the gradual breaking down of the relationship with Jake and Duda in favor of Jake wanting to go stay with his brother. So keep our eye for that. Then we see they're having some kind of celebration. I'm not quite sure where they're at. It looks like Papa's dancing with his girl. Then from there, we see my man Emmett, and you see that big smile on his face? Ladies, that's because he got him some. He's at Sonny's smiling from ear to ear, smile so big, get his ears wet. And that's what happens when y'all break a brother off with a little something, something. We get happy, make us smile. Then we see Ronnie somewhere where someone is shining a light on him. I have no idea what kind of trouble Ronnie's getting into, but I'm not calling him Rusty Ronnie no more because he's on a mission for his grandmother and for Keisha. Next frame, we see people darting through an alleyway. This might be that alleyway where Ronnie lives, where Ronnie formerly lived at. I think he's gonna clean himself up and he's gonna be moving on. I don't know what they're running from, but this is more than likely some of the chaos going on with the power being out. Maybe people have started looting and rioting. The city's going crazy because the power is out. And you might just be seeing people escaping. Then we see Kev and his girl looking down at something like they're reminiscing possibly about what's going on with Keisha. And in the very next frame, we find out what they're looking at. This is the girl whose body they found in the last episode that they identified wasn't Keisha because she didn't have a tattoo on her back. This is the same girl that was at the vigil when they had the posters up for Keisha and they had the posters up for this girl. So I guess they're just putting a mural out because she's dead and everybody's, you know, very sad, very somber about her death. And then we see Ronnie's grandmother. To end confusion, some people thought that he said his grandmother had died in the last episode. And I think he was just saying before she dies, he wants to be a hero for her. And here she is asking about Keisha. And then in the very last frame, we see Ronnie in the streets looking for something. And then we hear some girl's very, very afraid and sad voice screaming. Comment below if you think you know who that girl is. And leave me all your comments on where you think we're going with Duda versus Triggs, where you think we're going with Lena Waithe versus Duda, and do you think Papa's crooked pastor daddy is going to have a bigger role in what's going to happen on this season? That's going to do it for this video. Don't forget to like my video. Please comment, subscribe. Get yourself that life gain. Follow me and Larry as we go on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday nights at 9 p.m. We review The Shy. We're doing P-Valley. We're also doing stocks so that you guys can make those life gains with your money. And until that next Sex is Hell video, I'll see you.